Hello and have a good day. Today, I will be talking about Jocasta Complex through the lens of psychoanalytic analysis in the play Andre's Mother. Before I start this analysis and go even further, I would want to warn you that this video is contained with several spoilers, so to everyone who haven't watched or read Andre's Mother, I suggest you to watch it or read it beforehand. Or if you intend to get along with me, sit back, get a bag of popcorn, relax, and continue watching. Alright, first of all, I would like to enlighten you on the Jocasta Complex and what it is about. For your information, this complexity is an incestuous sexual desire of a mother towards her son. This complexity is basically the reverse version of Oedipus Complex, which is a concept that is coined by Sigmund Freud based on the Greek celebrated play Oedipus Rex. In the play, Oedipus unknowingly desires his own mother, Jocasta, sexually. Well, going back to Jocasta Complex, many believe that it is perhaps commonly happens with an intelligent son or the absence of a father's existence or accountability. Terence McNally, the playwright indeed, doesn't mention a single word of dad or even father at all in this play. Thus, it proves my statement that Jocasta Complex is happening in this play within the character of the play. As what I said, this intricacy can be glimpsed through the character of Andre's mother, Catherine herself. Her silence and absence of reaction indicates her own denial of the death of her beloved son with whom she deeply in love. Most reviews believe that Catherine's lack of love and care towards her son creates the major conflict in this play. However, I believe that it is the other way around. Well, yes, it is evident that Catherine despises Andre's sexuality through Carl's monologue. When Andre states that he's afraid of his mother's disapproval, which means that Catherine objects to her son being gay. However, her disapproval is in fact affected from her unrequited love towards her own son. She doesn't cut ties and neglect her own son because she scorns Andre's sexuality, but she is essentially disheartened of her unwritten desire. To emphasize this claim, I would point to Catherine's act of showing up at Andre's memory ceremony. This shows her never-ending love towards her son. Moreover, the line "just a little homesick call, just a little bit" as uttered by Andre exposes that he misses the love from home. The feeling of homesickness doesn't come from nothing. In fact, it comes from the affection given by the other party. Here, it is the fondness from his mother, perhaps implying Jocasta Complex within Catherine. In my opinion, Andre must have been given an abundance of affection from his own mother during his childhood, because otherwise he would not experience the state of being homesick. The affection that was given is seen as commonplace by Andre, as how everyone presumes it should be between a mother and a son. Conversely, it is not the same for Catherine. Based on my point of view, Catherine's action of kissing the balloon means more than just accepting the death of her son. The kiss, in fact, displays her affection towards her son. The kiss could symbolize an unwritten and tragic passion of a mother to her son. To conclude, I would like to say that despite the play is slightly short, it is indeed filled with a rich meaning and emotion. Of course, the play does not only revolve around the aspect of Jocasta Complex per se, yet I swear it delivers much more than that. That's all for me. Thank you for watching.